Good morning, everyone. Dr. Debs here, Dr. Debra Williams. So this morning I woke up early, as always, early to bed, early to rise. Meet with Jesus early in the morning. Meet with the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Pray. Consecrate yourself to God. Cover your family. You cannot start the day without God. So when I was finished having my prayer and worship, I was WhatsApping out my normal morning devotion. And a very dear sister friend of mine WhatsApped me. And we're there talking about, you know, what we're doing in our different kitchens and how we're teaching and the different recipes. And then she said to me, I'm going to make a chickpea scramble for my family. And I said to her, girlfriend, I wouldn't call her name, she knows who she is. That's going to make a lovely video. Because we don't eat eggs. No eggs, right? The eggs are too filled with hormones, steroids, and antibiotics that they're feeding to the chickens. So, and also eggs are high in cholesterol. You know, cholesterol clogs up your arteries and it causes you to come down with all kind of diseases. But we do a chickpea scramble and we use it instead of eggs, right? It's a healthy, delicious breakfast. So my precious friend, I call her my little sister, right? She's making that for her family this morning, and I'm gonna make it for you guys this morning. Now my girlfriend said to me, Debs, when you make all this food in these videos, what do you do with it? My staff, my neighbors, I give it away. I can eat all this food. I give it away, share it with persons. So everybody enjoying from Dr. Debs' kitchen, right? I even share it with my clients, those who come to the health food store, if my staff leave any to share. They give it to the clients. So we're going to use a half cup of the chickpea flour, right? So we have a half cup. Okay, there we go. So we have a little bit, one cup. I'm going to do one cup. Because I'm making four staff members plus my neighbor. All right, so this is one cup of chickpea flour, right? And that goes into my dish. Okay, now once I put that in, I'm going to add a half teaspoon of our Himalayan sea salt, right? So about half a teaspoon of the Himalayan sea salt. And once I put the salt in, now I'm going to add whatever I want. Now, you can add what you want. This is what Dr. Debs using this morning. So when I used to eat eggs, I used to love the scrambled eggs with this scallion and the onions in it. So when I'm gonna make my chickpea scramble, I'm putting the same things back in it, right? So my scallion and my onion goes in. Good. Now to this mixture, let me see if I can raise it so you guys can see what I'm doing. Let me find something to raise it. All right, there we go. Aha, there you go. Now you can see what I'm doing. Perfect. Okay guys, so we're going to use a half cup of water to this one cup of chickpea flour, right? So you pour a little first and you start mixing. Now I should have used a larger bowl, but it could work. All right. Now again, remember, whenever we're adding water to anything, you add a little until you get the consistency. Don't pour the whole thing one time and spoil the batter. So what we want to do is get a nice thick consistency until it moves around. Right, and it kind of runs off the spoon, but not too thin, not too thick, not too thin. Now some of you have been writing me back saying that you tried the planting flatbread and it was wet, or you tried the red lintels flatbread and it didn't come out quite dry. Don't worry, sir, just add a little more, maybe put too much water in there, right? So you just try and try until you get what you need. That's how I learn. That's how we all learn. Okay, good. So now add a little more water, right? Okay. I will just keep turning. There we go. Good. So now that's the consistency I'm looking for. See that? Right. Almost like you're making fritters. Beautiful. So now once I put that in, yeah, this is exactly what I'm looking for. See that? Alright, just as if you would have taken an egg and you would have mixed it up, and this is what it would look like, right? Now I'm gonna add my herbs. add whatever herbs you have. I have turmeric, so I'm adding a little turmeric, right? That's about a half teaspoon of the turmeric powder. I'm going to add a little of my sage because I love the taste of sage. About half teaspoon of the sage, right, in my mixture. I'm going to add some garlic powder, right, about half teaspoon of my garlic powder. Okay, and then remember I told you guys about my paprika, my smoked paprika. Love the taste of it in everything. So I'm going to put about a quarter teaspoon of that in there. Now once I put all of this in, I mix it up again, right? So you just mix it up. Mix it up. And just bring it all together. Perfect. Now once you've done that, you just simply get your coconut oil. So I'm using my cold pressed coconut oil. And you just put two tablespoons, right? And let's turn the pot. This is my stainless steel pot, right? But has in my oil. Make sure the pot is hot, because you don't want it to stick. So make sure your pot is hot. Now, let's get our spatula. That, yes, have to have one in the kitchen. Make sure your pot is very nice and hot. But if it's not hot, it's gonna stick. All right, so once the pot gets hot, so I'm gonna take this down now. Alright guys. Good. Now once we have this intact, we're going to pour in our mixture in the pot, right? So you just pour in the mixture. Pot is very hot. Alright, beautiful. Good. So you pour it in, right? And then remember you're making a scrambled egg, right? So you pour it in, pot is very hot, and you just start moving it around, right? Just start moving it around. Okay, there you go. You see the finished thing, right? You start moving it around. Okay. And it starts coming together quite nicely. And then you break it up, use your spatula and you break it up, right? Or maybe you're making a scrambled egg. Okay guys, there we go. So now take your spatula and you break it up, right? So you will have to break it up. All right, give it a chance, let the heat get into it. Remember the pot has to be very hot to get this done, to get this out properly. Get a fork, whatever's on the spatula, take it off. And then you just keep turning it, right? Just keep moving it around. Can you see that? Yeah. And then you break it up, right? Use your spatula. Break it up. Smells so good. Smells so good and it is so healthy. This is a healthy breakfast. And my girlfriend and her daughters and her husband this morning are going to be having this at their home in Kingston for breakfast. And Dr. Debs will be having some of it for her breakfast and my staff will be having some to taste it. Alright. So, oh, look at that. I wish you guys could smell this. It is so good. Now, I'm going to be serving this thing up with, you can have it with, I'm going to have it with my flatbread, right? And some cucumbers and maybe some avocado and bell pepper. And I think I have tomato, yes. I have ripe planted. Yeah, man, so everything is ready. You can have it with whatever you want. You can have it with some rice if you wish. You can have it with some quinoa, bami. You can have it with some breadfruit. Or you can make your flatbread and have it with your flatbread. So there we have our chickpea scramble, right? You just keep turning it until it's cooked right through. beautiful. So there we have it, in less than what? 10 minutes? Let me see. Yeah, less than 10 minutes. Just about 10 minutes. You have an easy, healthy chickpea scramble for the entire family to enjoy for breakfast. And if you wish, you could just get a nice glass container. Remember, we don't put hot, anything hot in plastic, right? And no microwave oven, no microwave. So get a lovely glass container. I just put it in the glass container, take it to work, and you can have this with a lovely salad if you wish. You could do lettuce with some of the purple onions, right? And just make a lovely, and you can get some sprouts. You know, you have Brussels sprouts, you have the alfalfa sprouts, and you can just make a lovely salad. You can have some avocado with that, and that could be your breakfast. Beautiful. All right, guys, and there you have it. Let's take the rest off the fork. I'm going to show you the finished thing in a minute. All right, and there we have a lovely scrambled chickpea. So instead of the eggs, no more hormone eggs, right? Causing up a hormonal imbalance, impacting the endocrine system, thyroid problems, fibroids, cysts on the uterus, fibrocystic breast, our men are coming down with prostate cancer, all these hormones, steroids, and antibiotics that they're packing in all of these stuff. So we're moving back to plant-based, right? And this is a handy friend. Now remember, I told you guys, if you have the chickpea and you have a good blender, just take the dry pea and grind it out and make your own chickpea flour. You don't have to buy this if you have the chickpea and really a strong blender to grind it out for powder. So now that we have done that, we turn off the stove and then now we go to the word, the word, the word, the word. I am so happy when I get the feedback from all of my friends telling me that they love the videos and they love this spiritual component in the videos. That makes me happy. It makes God happy. It makes you healthy spiritually. All right, now, so this morning from my study Bible, Dr. Debs is going to share with you from Matthew chapter 25, looking at the parable of the 10 virgins. Now the Bible says, and I'm going to read from verses 1 to verse 13. The Bible says, "Then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, who took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, 'Behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him.'" 7, verse 7, "Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, 'Give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out.' But the wise answered, saying, 'Not so, lest there be not enough for us," sorry, "and you. But go ye rather to them that sell, and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came." The bridegroom came, "and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Afterward came also the other virgin, saying, 'Lord, Lord, open to us.' But he answered and said, 'Verily I say unto you, I know you not.'" 13 and last, "Watch therefore, for he know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh." Let's now read the commentary explaining what we just read a while ago. Sister White says, from the book Christ Object Lesson, page 406, all the way over to 411. So if you want to get the full explanation, the full comments that God inspired her to explain this particular parable, I'm referring you to a book called Christ Object Lesson by Helen G. White. You can download it free online, or you can go to any Seventh-day Adventist bookstore and buy one. Page 406. The commentary says, the two classes of watchers, the wise and the foolish virgins, represent the two classes who profess to be watching for their Lord. So here we are, 2020. It says that of all the persons who are naming themselves Christians, saying that they're following Jesus, there are two classes. This is very serious now, so listen up. It says, they who profess to be waiting on their Lord. They are called virgins because they profess a pure faith. By the lamps is represented the word of God. All right. So both sets of Christians, yeah, two classes, they both profess the word of God. The oil is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. The class represented by the foolish virgins are not hypocrites. Not hypocrites at all. They have a regard for the truth. They have advocated the truth. They are attracted to those who believe the truth. But, here's the but now, guys. But, oh, Father, help us with the but story. But they have not yielded themselves to the Holy Spirit working. So, they're reading the Bible. They're going to church. They're saying, Jesus, Jesus. They're saying, I love the Father. But they have not yielded. They have not given their lives completely to God. So when you see them, they have the appearance of a Christian. They even sound, but the fruit is not matching up with the word. They have not consecrated themselves completely for the Holy Spirit to take control. So though they're in the word and they're calling God's name, the world is pulling them away. They say they're on the narrow road, but the broad road is dragging them away. So the love of money, the love of self, the love of things of the world, the love of recognition, this obsession with people and putting their hope and trust in people. Jeremiah 17 says, cursed is he who puts his trust in man, but blessed is he who puts his trust in God, God and God alone. The Bible says, our hearts are deceitfully, it's deceitfully wicked. Who can know it? Only God. As we yield day by day, that's why Bible study is so important in the morning. Every morning, it's a daily process. The Holy Spirit has to overshadow us. The world is trying to draw us away. The devil is trying to tempt us. But God says he will not allow us to be tempted more than we can manage. So daily, hourly, hourly, we yield to the Holy Spirit. As we see the temptations coming, Holy Spirit, we pray and ask God to give us the power not to fall into sin. So let us be, remember, you know, the Bible says the 10 virgins, all of them fell asleep. But when the midnight cry came, the bridegroom is coming, they all woke up back. But what happened? 5 have oil. So 50%. 5 have oil. Oil is what? The Holy Spirit. But 50%, 5 have no Holy Spirit. Have no Holy Spirit. Then they come to those now who have the Holy Spirit asking to give some. But I can't give you my oil. You cannot give me your oil. We have to individually surrender all to God and let the Holy Spirit take full control. It's a battle and a march, yes. And there's no letting up until we leave this place, right? The devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy, but Jesus came to give us life and give it more abundantly. And I always remember James, the Bible says, submit yourself to God. Resist the devil and he shall flee from you. So today is what? Today is Thursday morning. I think it's November 13, yes, it's a Thursday morning. Dr. Debs is very happy because Dr. Debs belongs to Jesus. Do you belong to Jesus? He loves you so much. He wants you. He died for you. Whatever the devil is using up there to trap you, resist that. Submit yourself to God and the devil will flee from you. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we thank you so much for the word. The word, we thank you for the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord, for the oil in our lamps. We thank you, Lord God, that the lamp is the Bible. But the Bible alone. Many study the Bible intellectually, Lord. But their hearts are not surrendered. Their will is not given to you. They want a Savior, but they don't want a Lord. They don't want Jesus to lead. I pray today, Lord, that you set some captives free. Even as you set me free, Lord. That day by day we come to you and we yield on our knees early in the morning, asking for the Holy Spirit. spirit, asking, Lord, for you to remove from us all the chains of iniquity and sin. And know fully well that you will always answer our prayers. Jesus says, none that comes to him will he ever turn away. So I pray, Lord, that you will keep me on the narrow road that goes through the straight gate that leads to everlasting life. I pray for my son, family members, my mom, friends, my staff, all of our patients and clients at the Center of Influence. I pray, Lord, for those beautiful friends who are supporting the ministry. I pray, Lord, for my beautiful girlfriend who gave us the inspiration to do this lovely chickpea scramble this morning. Bless her and her family. I thank you, Lord God, for all of your children on the earth. And I pray indeed that we will allow you to be God for us. You will tell us how to worship you in holiness. And we, like creatures, responding to our Creator, will trust and obey. There's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Thank you, Lord, for your love and your blessing. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. His merits, his righteousness covers us because we have none of our own, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Father, for the forgiveness of our sins in words and thoughts and deeds. And thank you, God, for cleansing us from all unrighteousness so that we can worship you in the beauty of holiness. Is our prayer with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So there you have it, guys. God bless you all. Love you much. Have a wonderful day from Dr. Debs.